Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to show you the first part of the French McCutcheon variation for black. For black means that I look at the opening from the perspective of the black player. But of course also viewers that play the white side of this opening will see many interesting things in this video. This video series is quite detailed, that's why I couldn't cover the entire opening in one video. Subscribe to the channel so you won't miss the next episode and you will become an expert in the French McCutcheon. In this first episode, we will analyze the four most interesting sidelines that we can meet at move 5. The McCutcheon variation is a variation of the French defense that arises after this e4, e6, d4, d5, knight in c3, knight in f6, bishop in g5, and here instead of playing bishop in e7 going for the classical French, as black we play bishop in b4. The main line continues with e5, attacking with the pawn, the pinned piece, and h6 with black that attacks the bishop. But in today's video we are interested in the main alternatives that white can play at move 5. So we come back to bishop in b4 and we start our analysis. Okay, so this is our starting position. Let's watch a bit more carefully this position. Both the white knight and the black knight are pinned. In case of a bishop capture, black can recapture with the queen, while white is forced to capture with the b-pawn, ruining his pawn structure. White controls more space in the center, but his e-pawn is attacked by the black d-pawn and it's not defended because, as we said, the knight in c3 is pinned. The first line that we will cover is 5a3. White attacks our bishop but doesn't defend the e4 pawn. Black answers with bishop capture in c3 we check, b capture in c3, and d capture in e4. So black is a pawn up and was able to ruin white's pawn structure on the queen side. The only interesting line at this point for white is f3. And my suggestion is to answer to f3 with queen in d5, defending the e4 pawn and also attacking the bishop. This is an interesting idea that provokes bishop capture in f6 for white, g capture in f6, and queen in d2, because it's a good idea for white to put the queen on the dark squares. Knight in c6, we keep developing. And now white has two main ideas. He can capture in e4 or invade our camp with queen in h6. Let's start with f capture in e4, also attacking our queen. We answer with queen capture in e4, we check. Queen in e2. Queen capture in e2, we check. Bishop capture in e2. Rook in g8, this is an important move because conquers the semi-open file with tempo, because the rook now is attacking the g2 pawn, g3 for white. Bishop in d7, knight in f3, and long castle for black. And black is better, and also a pawn up. Our analysis of this first sideline ends here, and we can come back to our starting position. Okay, so we are back to our starting position, and the second line that we are interested in is knight in g goes in e2. White doesn't protect the e4 pawn, but add the piece to the defense of the knight in c3. So we can capture in e4, a3, with the pawn that threatens our bishop, and here we don't want to change the bishop for the knight, because we can't ruin white pawn structure as compensation. That's why we come back to e7. Here we will consider two ideas for white. Bishop capture in f6 that removes the defender of the pawn, and knight in g3 that adds another attacker versus our pawn in e4. Okay, let's start with bishop capture in f6, bishop capture in f6, knight capture in e4. So White regained the pawn and now is threatening our good bishop that we don't want to lose. That's why we retreat the bishop in e7. And again here White has two ideas, because we can see that it's a good idea for White to play g3, because White bishop is blocked by the knight. And also another idea is to play queen in d3, that make us understand that White idea is to castle long. Okay, let's start with queen in d3, knight in d7, long castle for White, short castle for Black, g3. Again, this is a good move, because now in this line the bishop is blocked also by the queen, so it's easier and better to develop it in fianchetto. Rook in b8, that prepares our queenside attack and also removes the rook from the long diagonal, where White bishop will be very dangerous. Bishop in g2 and b5. And we end the analysis of this line here, because the ideas here are clear. Black will attack on the queen side and White will attack on the king side, but Black is fine in this position, and also his pawns will arrive to the contact point here, attacking White castle much faster than White pawn on the king side. So let's come back. We said that after bishop in e7, the other idea for White is to play g3. Again, knight in d7, bishop in g2, castle, short castle also for White. And what we played are all standard moves. c6 now, this is a good move, because it will limit the scope of the light square bishop. c4 for White. e5. And capturing now for White in e5 gives Black the opportunity to finish the development and gain an advantage with knight capture, c5, bishop in g4. Also, changing queens is not a good idea for White, because Black will also conquer the file. So, coming back to e5, d5 is the proper move. f5, attacking the knight, knight comebacks in c3, and d4, limiting even more White's bishop. In this position, capturing in c6 is very tempting for White, but is a bad move. Let's see, d capture in c6, b capture in c6, it's true that White ruined our structure, but also open some lines, and we must remember that we have the bishop pair. We will attack the targets on the dark squares, and we will try to penetrate in the enemy side of the board with the queen through the light squares. Let's see. Queen in c2, knight in e5, rook that attacks our queen, queen in c7, the other rook coming in the center, rook in b8, gaining control of the semi-open file, likely knight in d4, bishop in f6 for Black. And in this position we stop, because there are so many possibilities, but it's minus one for Black, and as you can see, is a good idea to attack in the center with rook in d8, the a pawn must be pushed in e5, the queen can come in f7. Before doing that, our king is just exposed on this long diagonal, so it's a good idea to put it in h8, but Black here has a lot more mobility for his pieces and has the advantage. But we said that White also had another option, so let's come back. We said that instead of capturing in b6, coming back, the other option was to add another attacker to the pawn, and we can see that there is no way to protect this pawn. So we play h6, attacking the bishop, bishop retreat in e3, castle, and let's see what happens if white capture with the knight. Knight capture in e4, knight capture in e4, attacking also the other knight, knight capture, f5, knight in c3, f4, attacking the bishop, bishop in c1, so it doesn't block the action of the queen, knight in c6, second attacker on the pawn, the pawn goes forward in d5, e capture in d5. Now white must recapture, and can recapture with the queen or with the knight. Capturing with the knight is a mistake, because here we have the tactical shot. Bishop in g4 attacking the queen, that is the defender of the knight. And white is forced to play queen capture in g4. So you can play the other alternatives by yourself as exercise. And after queen capture in d5, black is winning, because you see that white king is still in the middle of the board, while black already completed the development, the pieces are very active, and so black is winning. Coming back, after e capture in d5, the proper move is queen capture in d5, queen capture in d5, knight capture in d5, bishop in d6, but also in this position black is much better, because our goal is to prevent white from castling, and it's very easy in this type of position for white to lose in few moves. Okay, so let's come back to castle. So instead of capturing, the other option for white is queen in d2, knight in g4, knight capture in e4, knight in c6, because we have time to capture the bishop. And now if bishop in b5, we play f5, knight in g3, a6, because we don't care if the bishop ruins our construction, because more lines opened are better for us, because we will have the bishop pair. In fact, bishop capture in c6, b capture in c6, and as we said, black is better, because we have the bishop pair, and likely we will have two bishops against two knights in a position that will become more and more open. If white, instead of playing bishop in b5, plays bishop in e2, we exchange the knight on the bishop in e3, f capture in e3, f5, knight in f2, f4, e capture in f4, queen capture in d4, queen capture, e knight capture in d4, and here we stop our analysis, because we can see that white is better. And we also have finished our analysis for the lines that come from knight in g goes in e2, and we come back to our starting position. Okay, so the third line that we are going to analyze starts with bishop in d3. So with this move, white develops the bishop and defend the e-pawn. Here my suggestion is h6, that attacks the bishop. The bishop, of course, can capture in f6 or can move away. Let's start with the bishop capture in f6. We have queen capture in f6. And then white can capture in d5 or advance the pawn in e5. If white capture in d5, after e capture in d5, queen in f3, Queen capture in f3, knight capture in f3 and c6. Black with the bishop pair stands a little better in a position that doesn't give nothing to white. If after queen capture in f6, white advances the pawn in e5, threatening the queen, we have queen in d8. And in this position, the possibilities for white are many. We will analyze the two knight moves, knight in f3 and knight in d2. And we can briefly say something about a3 and queen in g4. So, if white plays a3, we simply capture the knight. If white plays queen in g4, we castle short. And black in these two lines has no problems. So, if white plays knight in e2, then we play castle, because we don't want to play c5, because now, after c5, if white plays a3, threatening the bishop, we are almost forced to change the bishop on the knight without compensation, because we will not ruin white pawn structure, because white will recapture with the other knight. So after castle also for black, and here we retreat the bishop in e7 to be able to play c5. In this position I have no games in the database, but black already equalized and stands also a bit better because he has the bishop pair. Coming back to our position, if instead of knight in d2 white plays knight in f3, now we can play c5, a3 for white, bishop capture in c3 we check, b capture in c3, queen in a5 attacking the undefended pawn, queen in d2, knight in c6. In this position, if white castles or plays c4, he lose a pawn, and you can calculate these two little lines by yourself as exercise. So in this position, we watch what happens after d capture in c5, queen capture in c5, castle for white, bishop in d7, generally white plays the rook in b1, attacking the b-pawn, so we have b6, a4 now, to avoid that the pawn is captured by the queen, rook in c8, that indirectly doubles the attack on the pawn, and here if rook in b5 attacking the queen, queen in a3 wins the pawn. So, after rook in c8, it's possible that white can play bishop in b5. And rook in c7, so we defend the light square bishop and we are able to move the knight and to castle. Rook in f goes in a1 and castle for black, and black in this position, as you can see, is a bit better because controls the file, the good white bishop will be changed, the pawn structure is better. Okay, so we analyzed what happens after h6 if white capture in f6. Let's see what happens when white moves away the bishop. If bishop in d2, protecting this knight and also unpinning it, we can simply play bishop capture in c3, bishop capture and d capture in e4, threatening the bishop, and after bishop in c4, black is already better and a pawn up. Coming back, If white after h6 put the bishop in h4, we have g5, and now white has two possibilities: to put the bishop in g3 or to advance in e5. If e5, we have g capture in h4, e capture in f6, queen capture in f6. Black is a pawn up and has the bishop pair. As you can see, we will castle longside, and black stands very good in this position. Coming back after g5, white can play bishop in g3. Now we capture in e4, attacking the bishop, and the bishop will move in c4. Knight in c6, doubling the attack on the d4 pawn. Knight in g goes in e2, protecting both the knight and the pawn. And now the interesting knight in a5, attacking the bishop. Here, of course, you can see that the bishop can't retreat in e3, and the knight is blocking his retreat in e2, so is forced to go in b3 or in b5. Allora, if bishop goes in b3, after bishop in d7, we will just change the knight on the good bishop of white, and we stands better. If bishop in b5 we check, we play c5, blocking the bishop attack and also threatening the bishop itself. Bishop in a4, we relocate the knight in c4, attacking the b2 pawn. Rook in b1 seems the best move to protect this pawn. Knight in d5 is centralized and doubles the attack on the pin and knight. The best move is castle, and knight capture in c3. In this position, white can recapture with the knight or with the pawn. If white recapture with the knight, then knight capture in b2 removes the defender, attacking the queen. So, of course, white is forced to capture in b2. And bishop capture in c3 attacks the rook. White can try with bishop in e5, attacking our rook. Bishop capture in b2, bishop capture in h8, b5, attacking the bishop. Bishop in b3, and c5 now is winning because it threatens c4. And also, this central pawn will fall because it's impossible for white to capture with the pawn, because after queen exchange, this bishop will fall. So in this position, black is winning because he is already two pawns up. Coming back, let's see what happens if white capture with the b pawn. B capture in c3. We retreat the bishop in e7, and we can see that white has a problematic bishop that could be trapped. In fact, if white plays bishop in b3, attacking the knight, we have knight in a3 attacking the rook, rook in a1, a5, and white can't save this bishop, even with c4, a4. So, if instead of playing bishop in b3, if white plays e3, after e5, the bishop is saved, but the position is still dominant for black. In fact, this knight is another piece that lacks good squares. The e3 push is very dangerous, because if captured, this knight jump fork queen and rook. and if not captured, it will defend the high jump in D2 with another fork. And so in this position the computer gives -2 for black. Okay, so we end here the analysis of the lines coming from 5 bishop in D3, and we come back to the starting position. So the last line, the last variation that we will study in this video is e capture in D5. Here we answer with queen capture in D5. And here the main move for white is bishop capture in F6. But let's quickly watch knight in F3 first. If white plays knight in F3, we play bishop capture in c3, we check, b capture in c3, knight in e4, attacking both the bishop and the pawn, the bishop come back in d2, defending the pawn, c5 now, and here the two main ideas that white can play are bishop in d3, attacking the knight, and here we play c4, bishop capture in e4, attacking the queen, queen capture, we check, and of course white must defend from the check, putting the queen in e2 or the bishop in e3, but in any case black has no problems because b6, bishop in b7 and short castle will follow, and black is fine. If instead, after c5, instead of playing bishop in d3, white plays c4, attacking the queen, we come back with our queen in d8, then bishop in d3, attacking the knight, now the knight capture in d2, queen capture in d2, c capture in d4, and we have a pawn more, but as black we are behind in development. If we castle as soon as possible, we will be fine. And now let's come back to the main move that after queen capture in d5 is bishop capture in f6. And here, before recapturing in f6, we play bishop capture in c3, we check, that ruins white pawn structure. B capture in c3. Now g capture in f6, and in this position the main moves for white are three queen moves, where white will relocate the queen with three different ideas, and the knight development in f3. Let's start with the knight development. After knight in f3, we have b6, bishop in e2, bishop in b7, castle for white, rook in g8, c4, attacking the queen, queen in e4, so we centralize the queen and we see that our queen is active and can reach the king side very easily, d5 now, knight in d7, rook in e1, white doesn't have danger of discoveries, so we can castle long. The discovery of the bishop is better in f1 because there the bishop protects the g2 square, and queen in f4. And in this position black is just a bit better. Coming back, now we will analyze the three queen moves. We will start with queen in f3. And the lines that come from queen in f3 are not very interesting. In fact, after the queen exchange, black is already equal and has better practical chances. So, queen capture in f3, knight capture in f3, again b6, because you see that in this type of lines We will develop the light square bishop in fianchetto, where it's very useful. Bishop in b5 now. King in e7, this is a good square for the king. Short castle for white. Bishop in b7. And again, in this position, in this type of position, black is perfectly fine. Coming back. The next line that we are going to watch is queen in g4, and here the idea is to invade in g7. We play queen in a5, threatening to capture with check in c3 and also win the rook. Knight in e2, that develops the knight and also protect the pawn. Bishop in d7. Queen in g7, attacking the rook. Rook comes in f8, where is protected by the king. Queen capture in f6, and capturing in f6 the queen doesn't allow black to castle. That's why we play bishop in c6, that gives the d7 square for the knight. And here the main idea for white is to play h4, and the idea is to keep pushing the h-pawn, capture our h-pawn with the queen, and go to the promotion. So it's a quite dangerous idea, but we can stop it. Starting with knight in d7, attacking the queen. The queen come back in g5. F5 now. And in this position, going for the check with queen in h5 check is not useful, because so, of course, also the check, the queen also attacking the pawn, but rook in f7 is an interference that also protects the pawn. Queen in g5 again, and knight in f6 is another interference that allow us to castle. So, coming back after f5. The queen comes back in d2, long castle for black. The game is equal, and even with a pawn less, black has better attacking chances. Okay, so the last line that we must watch is queen in d2, knight in d7. And we will watch briefly three lines. The one starting with c4 attacking the queen, and the other two where white will develop his knight. After c4 attacking the queen, queen goes in c6, where she controls the g2 square, knight in f3, b6, bishop in d3, bishop in b7. And black is better and ready to castle long. And in this position, it's interesting to notice that if white plays the wrong move, that is castle, the game is completely lost, because we have the queen sacrifice, queen capture in f3. If g capture in f3, rook in g8 we check, king in h1, bishop capture in f3, e checkmate. So, of course, instead of after bishop in b7, instead of castle, the move to play for white is d5, attacking the pawn and also the queen. E capture in d5, queen in e3 we check, queen in e6, because going for the queen exchange here is good for black, that will also get rid of the double pawn on the f-file. C capture in d5, bishop capture in d5, castle for white, a long castle for black. It's possible knight in d4 attacking the queen. Now we will exchange queens. F3 capture in e3. As usual, Rook in g8 to control the semi-open file, and in this type of position black is a bit better. If instead of playing c4, let's see what happens if white develops the knight in e2 or f3, and I must tell you that these lines are complicated, so we will just watch them quickly. But these two lines will bring to a position where the game is equal and also very interesting. Let's start with knight in e2, b6 for black, knight in f4, attacking the queen, queen moves in g5, h4 again, attacking the queen, queen moves in a5, d5, e5, attacking the knight, knight in h5, rook in g8, rook in d1, bishop in b7, and as we said, the game is equal and very interesting. Coming back, if knight in f3, again b6, c4, attacking our queen, queen in c6, d5, again attacking the queen, queen in d6, because if white will capture here, we will change queen and also get rid of the double pawns. White plays rook in d1, bishop in b7, bishop in e2. Long castle for black, short castle for white, and king in b8. And again, we have white with short castle and black with long castle. And the game is perfectly equal. Black is perfectly fine, and the position is also interesting because there are many attacking possibilities. And with this line, we end the analysis in this first video. In the French McCutcheon series. I hope that you enjoyed it. In the next weeks, we will keep analyzing the French McCutcheon with new videos. So, subscribe to the channel, thanks for watching, and goodbye.